that you completed rotation with gears, now we're going to move on to rotation with pulley. This is very similar to basically most of the robot that we had last year. We had pulleys on the hopper, intake, and shooter. They're just used everywhere. It's a very simple thing to do. So first we're going to do is create a document, rotation with pulley. This is going to be the name. We are going to make a sketch on the front face, do a rectangle. This rectangle is going to be 9 by 3. This is just a random number for this. Whenever you're designing something, you actually know what numbers you want to use. We're going to make the circle for the motor. For this case, we're going to be using a Kraken or Falcon. Falcon with a VEX gearbox. The Kraken doesn't have the adapter for it, so we can't use a Kraken with a VEX gearbox, but we can use a Falcon with the VEX gearbox. So we're going to do a circle here. We're going to have the circle be centered. So here. And then also remember the dimensions from the center of the circle. 1.5 by 1.5 is the dimensions of this circle. Or is the location of the circle, dimensions of the circle. Since this is a pulley, it's going to be, or since this is a one for, actually, this is one for a hex shaft. So we're going to do 1.125, 1 1/8 is the other term for this one. And then we're going to also add mounting holes. And we're going to do a line. And then we're going to do a circle. And we're going to dimension that. 0.201, and this is going to be 1 inch, and we're going to do a pattern, circular pattern. This is not exactly the same as the document, but we're going to do 8 spacing since this is a one for a VEX and a planetary gearbox. Everything is in a square shape, so we can do intervals of 2. And we're going to do 8 because that gives us the most flexibility of how we want to mount it if we were to do this in person. So 8, that gives us 8 different locations. Little check mark. Just left click on it. And now we have to do our spacing. So on the gear that we're going to have on the motor, we're going to use an 18-tooth gear or 18-tooth pulley. And then we're going to have a 24-tooth pulley on the other end. This will also. Gears and pulleys both can do reduction. This is our driving pulley, and it goes to our final pulley. It's going to have a reduction and give it more torque whenever we have a small pulley versus a large pulley on the other side. So we're going to use West Coast Products again. If we go to resources and go to belt calculator, we can say we got first got to change our pitch from 3 millimeter to 5 millimeter. And then we're going to do 18, and then we said we're going to do 24. And then we got to figure out about what distance we want to do for the distance between the pulley. We're going to just say that we want the distance to be around 5.8. And you can't just enter in 5.8 in here. You have to enter in what you want your desired distance to be, which is your approximate. And then you come to here. And you got to verify that it's in intervals of 10. We have almost all the belts in the intervals of 10. 80 is a very common one, so we're going to go with this 5.804 distance. Similar to a gear, you could do a big circle dimension, and then you do that distance times 2, and anywhere on this circle. You put a hole, that pulley will be able to have the right tension. We're going to keep it nice and simple. We're going to keep this one in line with that one. So when we do a dimension, we're going to dimension from the center. We're going to do 1.5, so that keeps it to the center. And now we're going to do another 1.125 hole spacing. And that is everything that we need for the plate. So we can go to this plate, we could do an extrude. extrude. And now we can select everything we want to extrude. And for this one, let's change the thickness to be 3/16. So we do 3 divided by 16. Of an inch. So that makes that thickness 3/16 of an inch. And now we can rename this part. We should do this beforehand. We could do this, call this one pulley. And similar to the other one, we're gonna need a hex shaft on the other end. So I just created a part. Hex shaft. So now we're going to do a top view again. Do a sketch on top view. Do a polygon. Select that part. Make sure you have 6 faces selected. Dimension this polygon to be 0.5. Check mark extrude. Select the part you want to extrude. Let's do 7 inches. And that part's done. So now we can go to our assembly. You can insert our hex pulley plate. We need one of those. We're going to need 1 hex shaft. And now what we're going to need is we're going to have to go to our standard parts. And let's look at gearboxes. And we're going to have a VEX simple gearbox. This here is just a very dumbed down version of the VEX gearbox. And we're just going to import it. And then we're also going to need a motor. We can import a Kraken. The Kraken and the Falcon have very similar sizes. So for this example, we can just represent it here. And then we're going to also need our bearings. Going to import 2 bearings. Technically, you don't need a bearing for your VEX gearbox, because there's already a bearing inside of it. We're just going to have another one just to get more practice. And then we're going to insert the pulleys. And remember, what pulleys we decided to use, we can go back to the website, we can use 18-tooth and a 24-tooth pulley. And for our pulleys in specific, all of our pulleys are going to be the 15 millimeter width. So you're going to see like the number then T times 15 millimeters. You want to find the right one. So the 12, we don't use those ones. The 18, 15, that's the first one we're going to use. And then we got to find the 24, 15. That's the second one we're going to use. If you do a 9 and you are really banking on that one being smaller width, it will not work. When you actually put it together in person, you're going to be too... It's going to be too big when it's all said and done if we don't have belts of 9 millimeter width. So let's do our mates again. Mate. Let's click on your circle, 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 and then you do a circle mate. And then let's have this bearing. Oh, well, should have thought about that beforehand. Let's fix this plate so that it stays in location. And let's actually mate circle. Come on shape, circle. You're gonna flip the rotation, made it. We're gonna try to drag this bearing out, and we're gonna mate here and here, and we're gonna do a planar mate, and that's all good. So now we could do a mate for the gearbox. We could do a mate. That's gonna be a planar mate. And then another mate. Any day now on shape. Mate, and then another planar mate. And then now we could do a circle mate with the hole. Circle, circle. And then do a planar mate. that edge. Click. Come on, man. Okay, and do a planar maybe. So that should fully define that, and then we can also do a circle mate with this one to circle, and we can have this represent the falcon. Let's do a planar mate with this face inside of there. So now the falcon's represented. We can do a circle. Nope, we're going to do planar mates. A planar mate, like so. And we're going to do a planar. We're going to drag. Didn't try to drag that part out that far. Drag that part out very slightly. Make sure it's still relative in the right spot. Mate. Planar. So now that part is almost fully defined. One more mate for that. It mates are gonna, you get faster with mates. Not gonna be as fast as SolidWorks, and you're depending on your Wi-Fi. It might take a little bit longer, but at least everybody can be involved with CAD now. We're going to do another circle mate. We're going to flip that bearing to be on the other side. If you don't flip the bearing on the other side, it'll throw faults. Don't know why. OnShape can't figure that out. Works in SolidWorks, but that's just me being bitter. We do a planar mate, get that bearing located in. And now let's get this hex shaft in to here. Let's flip the orientation. The primary axis, yes. And then we'll do another mate here. He's going to give it to me. I think it's this one. No errors, cool. So and then we're going to do the last distant mate. From here to that edge, we're going to do a planar offset 1 inch. And now that part is fully defined. The last set of mates we got to do is this pulley mate. Here to here. And then this back edge to this back edge. Planar mate. So now, what we got here is, if we were to, we could just daisy chain a lot of these. We could put one here, put another one here. Put another one here, like we did last year, and we could put them vertical. We could do whatever shape. This is so we can transfer motion with the pulley. There's no easy way to draw in the pulleys. What we did last year, we usually do like a side view and verify nothing is intersecting with each other. And that's basically it. That's rotation with pulleys. What I challenge you to do here is to change the length, the spacing from center to center, and also change the gear reduction. Right now, the gear reduction is 24 divided by 14, or 24 divided by 18 is 1.3. It takes 1.3 rotations to get one rotation output. Challenge you to make it have more torque. To make it have more torque, you would have to increase the number of the teeth here. And the gears that we have are, we for sure have 30 and 36. So you could choose between that, but with those ones, you're going to need different numbers. And don't forget the interval of tens. So, yeah, I challenge you to change the gear or change the pulley to have more torque on that end. And yeah.